Hi everyone, welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel. My name is Shukra and this is going to be another luxury bag review video. This is going to be a review of my Givenchy Antigone bag. So if you're on the market for a new bag during this holiday season, I do believe the Givenchy Antigone bag will be a great gift idea to give to yourself or to give to someone else as well. So if you're interested in hearing about my review, please keep on watching. So for my bag, for this Givenchy Antigone bag, I have it in the mini. So it's pretty, like, you know, dainty, kind of small. The structure of this bag is already kind of, you know, like, It has a definite defining structure to it. So the bigger you get it, you know, the heavier it can kind of be and bulky it can kind of be. So I decided to get it in the mini instead of going for like the small or medium or anything like that, because I figured this bag already, with the way it looks and the structure, I don't need it any bigger than, like, you know, the mini. So this is the front. It has, you know, Givenchy on it right here, and it is silver hardware, and this is in goat skin. I believe I picked this up in goat skin, and this is what the inside looks like. I actually have the dust bag inside of it. I like to keep my dust bags, of course. Like, if I don't keep the boxes, I always make sure I keep the dust bags because travel purposes and all that stuff, and you get to stuff it a little. So this comes with a strap, of course, so you can wear it cross body, you know, if you want, instead of just handheld like this. So the inside is just a big hole. It's a big black hole. There aren't any compartments. There is, you know, a zip area, like right here, if you guys can see that. And then in the front, there's like these little pockets, two pockets. I don't know if you guys be able to see. Let me see, this way. Okay, well, there are two pockets in the front, and then there's a zip, and then it has the strap, of course. So it can be with the strap or without the strap, whichever way you wanna wear it. I've never worn it with the strap. I've always just done top handle. I like top handles. I'm a top handle kind of girl, so I'm okay with like not having a strap or like making it crossbody or anything like that. And then this is what the bottom looks like. Looks just like this. Yeah, so I was a little hesitant to pick up this bag, even though I've always liked this bag. I've always wanted to have Antigone in my collection. The only reason why I was just hesitant is because of the silver hardware, but over the years, like, you know, I have grown, I have learned how to incorporate silver into my wardrobe, so it's not a big deal, but that did cause me some hesitation. But I've always loved the design in this bag. I feel like at this point, this bag is considered a classic, you know, with Givenchy. It's a classic. It's not like a sought after bag by everyone that's like, I must have it. But it's a bag that, you know, is worth it still. You know, you can carry it around day to day. This is in their goat skin, and it's kind of pebbled just a little bit, and it's really durable. Like, I don't have to baby this bag, and I feel like because of the amount of space, like, you guys see how much can be held in this. You can hold a lot in this bag. So that's why, like I said, I didn't go for a bigger size. I just went for the mini because I know I can hold so much in this already with the way it's structured. And I feel like the structure of this bag is so unique, and it's so nice, and it just stands out. I remember when this bag first came out, when this design first came out, the Givenchy Antigone was so sought after, and it's just like one of those bags that, you know, they really hit the nail on the head when, you know, they designed this. So props to Givenchy for this design. So the width of this bag is around like 7.7 inches. So that's not too much for the width. And then the height is like 5.3 inches about. I didn't measure, so yeah, about 5.3. And then for the depth of this bag, it is like 8.7. 8.7 is, like, you know, how deep the bag is. Like I said, this bag holds a lot. It really does hold a lot, and it's great. As far as the price for the Givenchy Antigone Mini, it's around $1,850 right now, $1,900. It's around that area. So on the Givenchy site, that's around the price. On Saks, that's the same price. You can also pick this up on Farfetch. It's always there. And for this bag, it's always, like, you know, better to kind of wait for sales, because this bag does go on sale at different retailers. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. Like if you do not want to pay full price, just wait for this to go on sale, or there's always some promotion or something going on with this bag. So I would recommend not buying this bag full price. I didn't buy mine full price. I got mine during a sale. So it's not like, you know, you need to spend the full amount. You know, there's always something up with this bag that allows it to be discounted somewhere, on sale somewhere. And then also, if you want something pre-loved, I would also go for the pre-loved route with this too, because the resale value for this bag, it doesn't really match the price that they have right now on the store website. I just wanted the black one to just, like, you know, have something that I know I could wear with a lot of different outfits. But yeah, so sales, discounts, pre-loved, I would definitely go that route with this. If you want to buy this brand new, that's all also fine too. Like, you know, brand new at full price, you can do that too. I'm pretty sure Givenchy wants you to buy it full price, so you can do that. And I just feel like it's a great bag. You'll have it for years and years, and it's a classic. I think it's a classic, and a lot of people agree that this bag at this point is a classic. When I wear this bag, I normally do not dress up this bag. You know, when I'm going out, I kind of wear this with outfits that are a little bit more relaxed, not too fancy. So this is definitely a great day bag. As far as a night bag, I guess you could wear this as a night bag and dress it up if you want, but I normally just see this as more of a day bag, a fun bag that, you know, you just wear with a nice casual outfit. But you can also dress this up. I think you could definitely dress, if you have the bigger one, you could definitely use it as a work bag or maybe a school bag. I think that would be a great opportunity to get the bigger ones if you want to use it for that purpose, because of how much they store, like, you know, and hold, and how they look too. This is definitely a bag that looks more professional the bigger it gets, so I would say do that. But as far as an evening bag, I wouldn't think of it as an evening bag, but you probably dress it up in a way to make it that way. But the way I've been wearing it has just been a casual day bag. Final thing is, would I recommend this bag? How do I feel about this bag? Overall, I love this bag. I like this bag. I've gotten so much use out of this bag. I really, like, you know, this is one of the first bags I added to my luxury handbag collection, because I knew I would be able to use this, and I knew I would be able to keep this for a while. So I definitely love this bag. I love that I got it in the goat skin. I hope I haven't been saying calf skin. This is goat skin. Yes, goat skin. And I feel like, even though it can hold a lot, it's still lightweight, you know? It just depends on how much you put in it, but it's still lightweight. It's still really nice. I definitely recommend getting this bag. I really like this bag. I feel like it's still in fashion. It's a classic, and it's durable. You can wear it a lot of different ways. It has the strap too, so you could use the strap if you want. I really like this bag, so overall, I am telling you guys, get the bag. And it's always on sale somewhere. You can find a discount or you can get it pre-loved. So this is a good bag to get if you're not, you know, if you're on a budget. If you're on a budget, I would say this is a good bag to get. This is a bag that you're not gonna break the bank for. And it's just, it's a great bag. So I guess that's kind of it for my review for my Givenchy Antigone bag. This is the mini. I would definitely recommend getting the mini. I feel like the bigger you go, then maybe you want it for work or school, sure, get the bigger ones. But other than that, you just go with the mini. And that's pretty much it for this luxury handbag review video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and found it helpful. As always, if this is your first time watching, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and come back for more videos. Bye!